Garden's looking better already, isn't it?
Yes, it is. I just need to pull out a few more weeds. Ah, thank you, snout grass.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, hello, magician.
Welcome home.
Oh, it's good to be back.
Dear, you do look tired.
Well, it's a very long, long walk from Zorn.
Why did you have to go there? Is it a secret?
No secret. I'd heard that an old friend of mine was very ill, and so I went to visit her.
Who is she?
She's an old, old owl. In fact, she's Mr. Hooter's grandmother.
Oh dear, does he know she's ill?
Not yet. That's why she gave me this letter to give to him.
I think he's in the gazebo. Shall we go and give it to him?
I think we'd ought to deliver it right away.
Right. Come on. Oh dear. He's asleep. It seems a shame to wake him.
Yes, but I think he needs to see what's in this letter. Mr. Hooter!
Oh, hello, magician. I haven't seen you for a while.
No, I've been all the way to Zorn to visit your grandmother.
Oh, dear old grandmother. How is she?
Well, she sent you this letter.
A letter? For me? Mm. Oh, I love getting letters. Will you open it for me, please, magician?
Well, yes, of course.
Isn't he a good reader? He doesn't even have to say the words out loud as he's reading them.
If you keep practicing your reading, Snodgrass, you'll soon be able to do that.
Oh, just imagine.
Oh, dear.
Is it bad news, Mr. Hooter?
I'm afraid it is. My grandmother's not well at all, and she needs someone to look after her.
Oh, who's that going to be?
Me.
You? But you live here, and so on's ever so far away. How can you look after her?
That's easy. I'll have to go and live with her in Zorn. Huh?
What? And leave us?
I don't want to leave you. But my grandmother needs me more than you do.
But you can't go.
I'm afraid Mr. Hooter's right, Toby. Someone has to look after his grandmother.
But when will he have to go?
Today.
Today? Oh, can't you wait a few days?
No. My grandma needs me now. So the sooner I get going, the better.
How will you get there? It's a very long way.
I'm a bird, aren't I? I can fly there.
But what about all your possessions, Mr. Hooter? There's your diary, your tin bath, your boat, lots of other things. Well, you can't fly and carry them.
No, that's a very good point. I expect I'll have to leave everything behind.
Oh, dear.
No, you won't. I'll fly some of your possessions to Zorn on my magic flying saucer.
Oh, would you, magician?
Hmm.
That would be very kind.
Well, we won't be able to fit everything on it, but I'll carry the rest on my next trip to Zorn.
Thank you.
How much will the flying saucer carry?
Well, the tin bath is obviously too big for it, and so is Mr. Hooter's boat. But it should be able to carry the smaller things. After all, it managed to carry Tessa Catchermouse when she went for a ride on it.
Lucky old Tessa. I wish I could have a ride on it.
Well, Tessa didn't think she was quite so lucky.
Why not?
Let's go over to the bird bath and find out, shall we?
Yes, and we can leave Mr. Hooter in peace to gather up all his possessions.
Aye. Off you go and leave me to it.
Right. Come on, everyone.
Come on, guys.
Now, you thought Tessa would be pleased to have a ride on the flying saucer, didn't you, Snodgrass?
Yes, I know I'd be pleased.
Well, Tessa wasn't. In fact, she was quite frightened, as you'll see.
One morning, Tessa Catchermouse woke up late. Her mother Pegs and her brother Tim had already gone out. I'll go out too, Tessa said to herself.
I'll go and see the magician. She went out into the magician's garden and climbed up a tree to the roof of the house. She looked down through the skylight into the magician's room. There was no one there. She climbed down a pole to the floor and ran across to the magician's chair. She jumped from the chair to the table. There was a big saucer on the table with strange patterns on it. As Tessa stepped into the saucer to have a better look, she put her paw on a little red button. At once, the saucer flew up into the air. "It's a flying saucer," cried Tessa. "I do wish it would fly somewhere." As soon as she said that, the saucer flew out of the window. It flew over the garden and out over Puddle Lane. It flew over the roofs of the houses in Candletown. "I'd like to stop for a bit and look," said Tessa. But the saucer flew on and on. Tessa began to feel frightened.
"Meow! I want to go home," she cried.
But the saucer flew on, over the fields, till it came to the river. Tessa was very frightened.
"Oh, dear," she cried. "I wish I was home."
And she sat down on the little red button. The saucer spun round and round and round, and Tessa nearly fell off. Then it started off again, flying back the way it had come. It flew over the river and over the roofs of the houses, over the trees and over the gardens, back to the magician's house in Puddle Lane. Then the saucer fell slowly down to earth and landed just outside the hole where Tessa lived. Tessa jumped off, and the saucer flew back to the magician's room. Pegs was just coming in through the garden gate, and she saw Tessa come home.
"Tessa," she cried, "where have you been?" "I've been for a ride in a magic flying saucer," said Tessa, "and I'm so glad to be safely home."
"I should think you are," said Pegs.
I wonder if I've got that story on my bookshelf.
I think you have. Yes, you have. Do you want to go through it?
No. I tell you what I want to do with this book. I'm going to give it to Mr. Hooter as a leaving present so he'll remember me.
Oh, that's a lovely idea, Toby. You know, I think we should all give him something to remind him of us. And I've got a new handkerchief here. I'm going to give him that.
And I've got two scarves, so I'll give him one of those.
Great.
And I can give him one of my pens.
Wonderful, wonderful. Now, what about the others? Now, Spencer isn't here, and I don't think Maple, Cauldron and Barrel have got anything they can give.
I know. Why don't we dig up a plant from the garden? Then Mr. Hooter can take it with him and plant it in Zorn, and then, every time a flower grows, it will remind him of everybody in Puddle Lane.
That's a wonderful idea, Auntie Flo. And we can give him all these lovely things at a grand goodbye party.
Oh, yes. Oh, dear, I don't think there's any food in for a party, and there's no time to make any.
Well, we'll just have to magic up a party. Toby and I can do that if you, Auntie Flo, can go with Snodgrass and get the scarf and the pen and the plant.
Right. Come on, Snodgrass.
Can you bring the flying saucer as well, please, Auntie
Flo? Yes, of course.
Don't forget that. Right. Come on, then, Toby. Let's go and mix that spell for the grand goodbye party.
Great. Come on in.
Barrel, we need a spell for a party.
Certainly, magician. What sort of party?
It's a goodbye party. Mr. Hooter's leaving us to go and live in Zorn.
Oh, dear. I am sorry. I'll miss him.
We all will. We're ever so sad that he's going, so we want to give him a special party, one that he'll always remember.
Then we'd better make it an extra special spell. First, we'll need a colour beginning with P for party.
Pink.
Pink. I do believe I've got some pink paper here somewhere. Yes. Pink paper for a party.
Thank you. And since it's a goodbye party, we ought to have something beginning with G.
G.
G. G. I know. What about some grass?
Oh.
Here we are. Green grass.
Now the magic tune, as everybody remembers except you, magician, goes pom, 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 pom.
I remembered. All together now.
Pom, 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 pom.
Now the magic clap. And finally, the magic rhyme. Puddle muddle, muddle puddle, Hooter's leaving. Help us get muddle puddle, puddle muddle. A goodbye party he won't forget.
Where am I? What's all this?
It's a special goodbye party.
Yes, just for you, Mr. Hooter.
Yes, something we hope you'll always remember.
Hello, everybody.
Ah, good, Maple. Now, everybody's here.
Yes, now, I've got all Mr. Hooter's presents and the flying saucer.
Good. Now, remember, Mr. Hooter, I'll take all your big things on my next trip to Zorn. Your tin bath, your boat, and your diary.
Thank you. But don't bother with the diary, magician.
Why not?
Because I'm giving it to you, Snodgrass and Maple. It's your diary now.
Oh, good. We can write down everything that we do in it, and then when you come to visit us, you'll be able to read it and find out everything that's happened.
That's right.
Oh, Mr. Hooter, I don't know what to say. Thank you.
We'll take care of it, won't we, Toby?
Oh, yes.
And we'll write something in it every day.
Good. Well, it will be a little something for you to remember me by.
And we've got some things for you to remember us by. Look, there's a book from Toby, a scarf from Snodgrass, a handkerchief from me, and a pen from the magician. Oh, and a plant from our garden.
Oh, yes. You must plant it as soon as you get to Zorn. And when the flowers grow, it'll remind you of all your friends in Puddle Lane.
Oak, what a lovely thought. It almost makes me feel like crying.
Oh,
don't cry, Mr. Hooter. All these lovely things are especially for you. This is your grand goodbye party. And this is your goodbye song. Music. Goodbye, old friend. Goodbye. We hate to see you go. We're sad, we'll try to smile, so our tears won't show. Our love will travel with you, and in our memory you'll stay. And though we'll sorely miss you, we'll meet again someday. But the time has come for leaving. We know that you must fly. And though our hearts are grieving, we won't let you see us cry. Goodbye, old friend. Goodbye.
I think I'd better go now before I really do cry. Goodbye, all of you. Thank you for being my friends.
Oh, we'll always be your friends, Mr. Hooter.
Yes, and you will always be ours. Safe journey.
Goodbye!
Goodbye,
Mr. Hooter!